community programs have been these attempts to impose self-regulatory ideals and practices that wound up sort of coming back, you know, to haunt them and even be destructive. And certainly one of the reasons for the, you know, basically taking down of the Oryk by Reich finally was the realization is, oh, you know, these people can't, you know, this can't happen in this kind of community. So the final question then is, how does an orgonomist, someone who practices orgone treatment, understand and use self-regulation in treatment? So the first thing is, you know, to remember for myself that I tell patients that if we are successful, they will be capable of, one, struggling more, you know, naturally and freely, more effectively. Struggling, with the emphasis on the word struggle. Some people don't like that word, you know, because the implications of that struggle is a negative. In my vocabulary, in my usage, struggle is a very positive, and that struggle is the essence of living, you know, of natural living. And self-regulation, really, in one sense, can be defined by the ability of the organism, the living organism, to struggle efficiently and more effectively in its own interest, right? In its self-interest. Okay. I also point out that that if we're successful, treatment will allow you to regulate your own life, you know, and interact in social and environmental circumstances much more rationally. You know, rationally is an interesting word. To me, the way I define rational is that rational equals biological and social regulations and biological and social self-regulation. Biological and or personal self-regulation, or my favorite diagram, which I invented, okay?
Pretty much.
That you have the biophysical process, which is a self-regulatory process, okay? That is always, inevitably for humans, is always organized in nature, in a environment, in a natural environment. For humans, that natural environment is mediated by a socio-cultural, no, it's not the state. Just social and culture, so society and culture are just different expressions of the same thing. This is always organized by the, so one is organized by two, and that equals our psycho, emotional experience and behavior.
One is organized by two or the other way?
One, the biophysical is always organized by the social, by the social cultural, which produces three, which is the emotional and psychological, what we call the psychological experience, right? But in reality, all of this equals the self, or in one sense, a self-regulating organism. I mean, if it works, or if there's no block in any of this, or no interference. Interestingly, when you look at societies that organize this properly, each of these kinds of developmental processes lay over each other in perfect grid that produces a, you know, synchronistic behavior that produces a highly functional, highly successful, highly effective struggling organism. When the grid is out of sync, it produces, as I like to say, usually, particularly produces that young adulthood, something called adolescence. You know, basically a self-generating psychosis of various sorts that can only be treated with alcohol, drugs, compulsive sexual behavior, compulsive eating, etc. But again, this is, in one sense, to me, the summation of, or the schematization of, you know, what a lot of what Reich is talking about in terms of what the goals of orgone treatment would be, but also orgone treatment as a means of facilitating or building or hoping to build individuals that are capable of increasing levels of pulsatory self-regulatory function, which then are capable of tolerating higher degrees of, in theory anyways, self-governing, social organization, and reduction in population size, and all the things that we dream. And that's theory. In treatment, on a day-to-day basis, with any one of us who is in treatment or with an orgonomist or anyone who does the clinical treatment, you go step by step and you go moment by moment in terms of increasing the capacity of the organism. It varies for each of us. It varies for each of us at different times in our lives. Reich was very clear that obviously the younger you were when you began to increase the capacity, or the more you could interfere with the imposition of these compulsive, non-self-regulatory conditions, the greater the more likely you were to prevent the damaging, effects of this type of compulsive imposition. But once it's there, the possibility of increasing that capacity is what therapy and the treatment offers. To the degree that it's successful, it is. And if to the degree that it's not, one complains or one, regrets. But you move as effectively or productively as you can. So those would be my remarks specific to it. And I think we could open the remainder of my time to questions and possibly move into even a general discussion if you have questions for the other participants after asking me some questions.
I have a question on your schema since you just remembered. Did you say sociocultural determines biophysical?
Doesn't determine, it organizes it. It has to. There's no way to avoid that. It's the nature of the human organism. All living organisms engage or exist and function in an environment. So the pond scum of the amoeba is its environment. It organizes the amoeba in many ways, even though the amoeba is a particular life form unto itself. So for humans, our environment is natural. I mean, it's the air we breathe, the land we walk, but the overall mediator and organizer of our interaction with our environment is always social and cultural.
Wouldn't it be a more dialectical relationship? Because we would have, as individual organisms, have an impact on...
Yes, that being true, yeah. It would be incorrect to say that we don't then affect the environment that we live in. I mean, and that will take us to a whole other, but yes, that added to the fact that we then, it's an ongoing, ongoing.
It may be a semantic thing, that's what I'm trying to be clear. In Reich's schema, he's putting biological as deeper than sociocultural.
It is.
So where are these two going?
It's not that they go together. The biological is the in Reich's terms, the biological is always central. That's why it's in the center here in my schema. It's always central. It's always inevitable. It is naturally. It's a natural function. The nature, and it's not random, it's pretty predictable once you understand the basic parameters of the living organism that you're dealing with, the life form. The socio and cultural is much more complicated. It can be very much more variable. It can vary in a wide variety of ways. As anyone who studies cultural anthropology and social organization understands. And